This is the story of the fall of the Soviet Union. The Soviet Union, the largest communist land, had 15 republics that were centrally planned. In the Soviet structure, Moscow organized all the big republic of Russia, plus the ones that were small. This communist form of public big industries had central planning providing all the necessities. But up-to-date little goods come faster if there's competitors. They could not stay modern with just big central leaders. And since World War II, East Europe had been divided in ways that were not what each place would have decided. There was not enough freedom, just one old gang in the middle. The war budget too large and people's voices too little. Then 1985 brought a younger guy to the top, and this guy Gorbachev wanted these problems to stop. Gorbachev started glasnost, more free speech and free news. It was fine for the first time to express many views. Gorbachev's perestroika brought democratizations. For the first time, elections let people steer their own nations. When the Berlin Wall fell, Gorbachev was surprised, but he slowed the arms race and won a Nobel Peace Prize. But then through East Europe, former Soviet states chose to break from the Union and control their own fates. So Gorbachev sighed, but chose democracy's course. He said he'd keep things together just with discussions, not force. Old communist leaders feared big changes too fast. The whole strength of the Union might be lost to the past. But new leaders and voters wanted change to come faster. Gorby's middle reform plans now were facing disaster. See, as Soviet president, Gorby wasn't defeated, but each republic's president now had strength just like he did. And Russia's president Yeltsin wanted more strength by far. So they drafted new plans for a looser USSR. But before this new compromise could be implemented, 8 conservative communists launched a coup to prevent it. They kept Gorbachev trapped, but people rushed out to help defend the Soviet Congress that they had elected themselves. And Yeltsin joined the people and the coup met defeat. But the old Communist Party now just looked obsolete. So when Gorbachev returned, he was the leader of zero. The Union structure was dead, each nation had its own hero. The Soviet Union is now no more, he announced, and Gorbachev sadly left, and Russia's president pounced. Yeltsin said it was time for the big free market test. Public resources should open for anyone to invest. But when the parliament leaders and the public protested, Yeltsin ordered the army to have them killed or arrested. So all profits went private or were bought up offshore. Millions and millions of normal people turned poor, and the Soviet Union died before it enjoyed the system Gorbachev wanted fixed instead of destroyed.